facility. You create something which will have, for this creation, need to get money. You have to run it, you make profit, inshallah, then you distribute. This is the flow chart, or this is the logical flow of your working as a financial manager. Unfortunately, we don't talk much of this. I don't think we are discussing much of this. In whatever I am planning to discuss with you, this will also become important.
I don't think we have discussed working as a source of capital.
You have discussed the following. There are two types of funds you can get. One is equity. It is easier to remember it as own funds. Debt. And debt also, there are two types. One is issue of bonds. The other one is borrowing from banks. Mainly from what? This is tradable debt. This is not tradable debt. This is one to one, or what we count as one to one, or one to a few. Right? In this, we have the following. You have loans, you'll have single bank, you'll have multiple banks, or in India we call it consortium. Or you have a different loan syndication. Just giving you the jargon or the possibilities wherever you need, you can use them in future.
What is the difference between consortium and loan
syndication? The difference is, this is one bank, you understood. You go to one bank. In consortium, you go to a couple of banks. You go talk to State Bank, you go talk to HDFC, you go talk to this thing, and they agree to this thing, then they all sit together and say, okay, you get this thing. In loan syndication, there is an intermediary who is like a broker for the borrower and the lender. So the intermediary, the loan syndication person or the loan syndicator, takes on this job. He prepares the models, he prepares the proposal based on the facts and figures of the company or the proposed project or whatever it is. Then he approaches, he brings out the document called a proposal document or a loan syndication document. And this document is distributed to various banks. All the banks, you know, the usual big banks. And the banks study that, and then they say, okay, we will give so much of money, or we will take so much of exposure as we call it. So somebody will say, I'll give you 10 crores, I am willing to take 10 crores of exposure, somebody says 100. But then, if it is oversubscribed kind of thing, then the loan syndicator sits together and decides amongst themselves how many is there. So all the interested banks meet together and they decide what it is. And each bank would have said, I will give it at this rate or that rate. Then they come to a common agreement. So in this case, there is an intermediary. In this case, the bank, normally the company goes to the bank. This is an Indian term. This is a term which we have taken from the West. It's becoming popular now, especially because very large amounts are involved, especially in the infrastructure projects.
Sir,
this loan syndication
provided by merchant bankers?
Yes. Need not necessarily be merchant bankers. It is provided by bankers. In India, it is provided by banks which do the actual lending of them. They are not. It is done both by commercial banks and by merchant banks in India. It is not a merchant banking activity. If you look at it here, it's a banking activity. The bank has one division takes on the
job is like under.
All sorts of things are important. There is a bid for it. Then because loan syndication fees are given. want to learn that, there is a case which I think I have a soft copy. I gave it to you. This was written when Chase had done his own investigation for Bicknell and Hong Kong. There are full details of that. If you want PPT, I'll do my PPT. You can just read Wikipedia and just go to there. Basic process is like merchant banking. You have a project, you approach these banks. There are what are called trade papers. You can see which are the banks who are doing loan syndication. There are what are called performance tables. There's not performance tables up there. They show who has done how much, etc. There's some ranking, is the highest loan syndicator, next highest. Like in India, SBI caps the loan syndication, SBI does loan syndication, ICICI Bank, Axis Bank, HDFC Bank. These are all ABN AMRO. These are all very active in it. And once there is a project like this, these guys come like flies, they come and tell you that we are loan syndicators, they are doing so. You know, they do their marketing, so you know who is a loan syndicator. Then you ask them for the bid. They say, suppose you 2,000 crores, you need for a power plant, and can you do the loan syndication for this? Then they will say, okay, we'll do it. Our fees are the following. They quote some fees, which will be normally a percentage of the total amount. There could be sub-syndicators, you know, there are many levels of that. I try to do that case. Otherwise, it's available in a book, you know, it's a Howard case. I'll give it to you. There's only one book, and now there's some professor out there. 5, 6,000 people. And they give the quotation. Naturally, we take the lowest quotation and take into consideration whether this loan syndicator, this organization has a history, whether they have done this earlier, etc. And if you award it to them, then they prepare the proposal document and they start, you know, then they go and get it. Something similar to an IPO. But it is not regulated by the SEBI. It is not regulated by the SEBI. It's an age-old process. I mean, it's been in the West for a very long time. In India, it's becoming popular now. And then they will do the syndication and they will say, this bank, this bank, this bank, this bank will give so much of money and this is the rate of interest, these are the terms of this. In a loan you also have what is called, this is relevant to you now. One is total amount, that is sanction. The other one is called drawdown. I am using words which are technical so that you can deal with this because of this care. What drawdown means? Is that suppose you are given a 2,000 crores loan, do we take it today? The moment you touch it, it's like our car these days. The moment you sit in the car, it gets devalued. Take it out of the showroom, you can't sell it at the original price. The moment you touch it, you have to pay interest. And you have to pay interest on the entire. So, the borrower would like this in a schedule, in a particular way. He cannot, there are two ways. The borrower can tell the banker, I will take whenever I want. Then it becomes very difficult for the banker. The banker will give you. Banks will provide any service to you, but he will charge. So, if you tell the banker that I want on day 1 so much, day 10 so much, year 1, year 2, the proper utilization, that will depend on your plan. You must plan your project. If project progress will be there, we want it on the day. That schedule, the borrower will give this indicator. It will be part of the proposal document, and that is what they draw down schedule.